Today.
So I came to this protest because people are celebrating Independence Day. America's not independent. We are owned by Israel. Israel's fucking us in the ass. They're taking our money. They're spending it to kill my people in Palestine. Okay? And AIPAC, literally, the American Israeli Foreign Committee, they should be registered as a foreign agent. They have this country by the balls. They are fucking us in the ass. That's just how it is. Instead of spending money in the school system and in our education and in the infrastructure and in helping the American people, we are helping a literally Nazi Zionist chimpanzee country kill civilians. Not only that, you are not allowed to criticize Israel in America. I mean, take New York Post, for example. They call me anti-Semitic, not knowing I'm a Semitic Palestinian. I took a DNA test. I'm Semitic. So New York Post, you're going to get sued for being anti-Semitic against a Palestinian who is Semitic. I mean, look at the retardation we're living in. Also, a lot of corporations like Sherwin-Williams, Lowe's, AutoZone have rejected my application because I'm Palestinian. So there's going to be a lawsuit right now. I'm going to become rich. I'm going to act like an Israeli. I'm going to use the court system to my advantage. Because in America, for now, we have something called civil rights, called defamation. So you guys played yourselves. So New York Post, you did not change the story, even though I have the full video of what happened at Queens College. You guys didn't change it, so now you're going to get sued. Get ready to pay me, baby!
Can you explain about this New York Post article to our viewers?
So, what happened? New York Post did an article back in November 29th, 2023, where they have a picture of me or a video of me telling some Zionists to go back to Poland, Germany, and France, but they're not giving you the full video. The full video, which I'm going to give you, the journalist, says that there was these ugly Zionists that look like pigs. They told me to go back to where I came from. I'm not American. I told them, okay, using that logic, you're not from America either. You should go back to Poland, Germany, France, Morocco, Egypt, because that's where these Zionists come from. I mean, if they're lucky, they're from Brooklyn or Manhattan, but putting that aside, you know, if you're going to tell me to go back to where I come from, I want to do that, but I can't because you motherfuckers came and took my land. It took my country. So that's the context. And being against Israel, let me be crystal clear, because New York Post is going to take what I say out of context. I am against the Holocaust. I am not anti-Semitic. I am against the Nazis. I am against anti-Semitism. Hell, I'm Semitic. So if I'm anti-Semitic, I'll be against myself, because Palestinians, if they do a DNA test on Palestinians, we are Semitic. So I'm going to sue the New York Post for being anti-Semitic towards me. That's how we're going to play this game.
And now about today's protests here, there's a large number of people here. Why do you think there's been a shift in discourse towards the Palestinian issue in the last several months?
What we have seen is, yes, there's a shift in discourse, but here's the problem. Look what happened in the Jamal Bowman race. AIPAC made it clear that they call the shots. They did gerrymandering, they redrew the district to make sure that Jamal Bowman's opponent wins. The United States is clearly under the control of Israel. Israel has America by the balls, and Israel will be the reason why America falls to pieces, because Israel will use America in its coming war. When they go into Lebanon, they will try to get America involved. And I'm not planning on fighting for Israel. Fuck them. And people are going to be like, oh, but does Israel have the right to defend itself? No, Israel has the right to get fucked in the ass. That's the only right Israel has, to get fucked and gangbanged in the ass. That's the only thing they deserve.
And what do you think of the turnout of these protests here?
I mean, it's average. I'm asking a question. Where's CNN? Where's Fox News? Where's ABC, NBC? Where are they? And plus, I have a question to the American people. Are we really free? Are we really free? I mean, you guys are paying more taxes than ever. We are giving aid to the Zionists in Palestine to get genocide, to kill my people, to build settlements, and to give money to other countries like Saudi Arabia, Jordan, and Egypt to protect Israel. But we don't have enough money to help our own people. What the hell is going on here? What happened to America first? I have a saying, America first, not Israel first. America first, not Israel first. So we're going to see, the Zionists, they don't like that. I was on Fox News and I said that. I said America first, not Israel first. And they lost their shit. Because it's true. We have to put our country first, not Israel first. Screw Israel. I don't care if Israel's about to get destroyed. America first. Pay me first. So that's my stance.
Okay. And what do you plan to do today? Are you planning to march? Are you planning to...
I'm planning to speak with a lot of media outlets to get my story out about the New York Post and how basically now if you're an American citizen, if you criticize Israel, you're going to be blacklisted, like me. I was blacklisted. And basically to get my story out and to tell the Israeli lobby and to tell the people who are trying to not let me get work, I'm coming for you legally and you're going to get fucked in the ass.
Now it's July 4th. Some people, like Americans, would feel like, why raise a foreign flag? Why wave?
Okay, hold on. What? July 4th? What's the purpose of it? We fought against tyranny. The American people, fought against tyranny because the British wanted us to shut up. The British came into our houses. The British taxed the crap out of us, and we fought to tell the British, we are not your bitch. America stands alone. Today, Americans must wake up and realize and tell Israel, get the fuck out of our country. Tell all these Israelis, stop controlling America. We refuse for America to be Israel's bitch, and we have to fight this occupation. Just like Palestine is under occupation, America's under occupation. Israel controls our media outlets. They control our, our politicians through lobbying, and they have our country by the balls. So I tell the American people, when is enough enough? Even Candace Owens woke up. Is Candace Owens anti-Semitic over a sudden? I don't know. The right used to love her. The Zionists, they used to love her. Now they're like, oh, she's anti-Semitic. I mean, Israelis are being called anti-Semitic for protesting their government and asking for the hostages to come back. So they have cheapened the word. The word anti-Semitism has become cheap. And plus, I'm Semitic, motherfucker. If you call me anti-Semitic, I'm suing your ass, New York Post. So, yeah.
And I'm trying to ask more. What do you intend to get out of from this protest? What do you want to see?
To get media attention for the Palestinian cause in my case, and to basically tell the American people, look, just like America has the right to defend itself and get its freedom, the Palestinian people have the right to get their freedom as well. The Palestinians are fighting for liberty, for freedom. For liberty, for freedom. Freedom to have our own country, freedom to vote, not to be under this apartheid regime, and to basically tell AIPAC and tell the Israeli government and tell our politicians we will fight for our freedom just like the founding fathers fought for our freedom in the U.S. in July 4th, 1776.
Okay. And
any other questions?
Yeah. What do you feel about the organizers at these protests?
I think the organizers, they do good things and bad things. I'm going to be very crystal clear to Mrs. Kiswani. We have to start protesting in Kew Gardens and Forest Hills, because why not? There are Zionists that come to Astoria and they protest. I think God promised us Kew Gardens and Forest Hills. We should protest in that area. That's American territory. I want the Zionists to know that there's Palestinians willing to protest in that area. And also, we should be protesting in front of the Israeli embassy, the Israeli consulate, and basically give the Israelis hell for doing the genocide, to make sure we shut down their businesses and protest in the streets and give them a headache. So that's my recommendation. Second, we need more lawyers. We need more lawyers to start suing New York Post and to sue all these companies that don't hire me. They don't hire Palestinians like myself. And they should be put in a position. We should tell the United States, these corporations and these government and the government institutions, that if you mess with Palestinian Americans, if you mess with Muslim Americans and our rights, we will take legal action. And I'm telling other organizations like CARE and Palestine Legal to step up. Stop being a chicken and take the case.
Now, my couple of final questions I have. Did you watch the debate last week?
Yes. Trump called Joe Biden a bad Palestinian, which I'm like, bro, Joe Biden is an Israeli. He's Israel's bitch. And I tell Mr. President Trump, if you want to win the election and you want to be president of the United States, cut the aid to Israel. Stop helping Israel. Fuck Israel. Let them get destroyed. Okay? And because they are milking us like a welfare queen. You know how sometimes people say that while you're on welfare, you're milking the system? Israel has been milking America since 1948. They've been fucking us in the ass. They've been milking us. So when is Israel going to get off welfare? When is Saudi Arabia going to get off welfare? When is Jordan going to get off welfare? As a matter of fact, I encourage every American to apply for welfare. Because if you don't apply for welfare, Israel will take it all. So I might as well apply for welfare and milk it myself.
Do you have anything else you want to say? Any parting comments?
Fuck Israel. Fuck New York Post. I'm coming for New York Post. I'm going to sue you. Get ready to pay up.
Thank you. Can you spell your name?
My name is Nas.
You have a last name?
My last name? Howard. Nas Howard.
All right. Thank you.
I'm offering you money to be a man.
Stop being ignorant. Stop being ignorant. You're a shame.
He's coming. You better start swimming. Swim back to your. He's coming.
Occupation no more! Hard things happen! generation no more.
1948.
What's your problem?
What schools are we going to do in America?
What's your problem?
1948.
Of over 40,000 Palestinians!
In the last 9 months alone!
Genocide Joe has got to go!
For the last 9 months!
For the last 9 months!
For them to tell us!
And now we have to!
Put Palestine to the side!
And vote for the genocider in chief!
Genocide is not!
The lesser of two evils! And whether it is Biden!
Or it is any other candidate that they pick to be in office!
Every single one of them!
Is complicit in genocide!
Of the Palestinian people!
Genocide!
It's a bipartisan issue!
And like Joe Biden said!
If there were not an Israel!
The U.S. would create one!
Because the U.S. invests!
In war and genocide!
Of people around the world!
This is why! Our fight is not! Just against one president!
Our fight is not!
Just against APAC!
Our fight is the system!
That enables genocide!
In Palestine and around the world!
This did not start!
On October 7th!
The Palestinian people!
Have been resisting!
And have been mourning!
For over 75 years!
Not even in the West Bank!
Number one terrorist. people.
Yo, call off Officer Ahmed. Not
bro,
a good idea.
Sellout 101, bro.
Officer Ahmed is a sellout. Officer Ahmed, you're gonna wear the hijab and brutalize other hijabis?
Yeah.
Put the riot gear to go.
How many hijabis have you brutalized, Officer Ahmed? Officer Ahmed, how many, do your parents know you're out here?
Your parents are from your audience right now.
Nah, he died my flight, don't worry about it, I'll catch him.
His people with them?
Yes.
What? Yeah. With them? Come with us. Let him come with us. Let the black guy come with us. He's coming with us. Nah, he's taking the black guy. The rest of y'all niggas. Nah. Yo, the black guy good. Yo, community affairs, the black guy's good. The rest of them, I don't give a fuck. The black guy's good. I swear to God. You can come. Come, nigga. You can come. You can come. I swear to God, you good with us, nigga. You good with us. Why are you holding? You don't want to be with y'all. What the fuck are you holding for? Yo.
That's bad.
How much shame do you feel right now? 40K a year. 40K a year with a shitty bitch.
No freaking way. 40K a year.
Everyone's going. You gotta stay back. This is the last day here.
My sergeant is over there.
That's it. He's fucked up now.
Yeah. nobody.
Thank you.
If you remain in the roadway and refuse to use the available sidewalk, you will be subject to arrest.
Are these your guys?
This is the New York City Police.
Yeah.
Gaza. 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 Gaza.
Gaza.
Out of here.
Can't breathe.
In and it would just, I hate to be like, yeah, yeah, like, but I still might come up with like, if he says for sure, then like, you know, I mean, like, I would say
a little bit.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
charge you with genocide.